Aujourd'hui, nous allons voir à passer à la leçon numéro 2. Good morning, students. Today we are going to start lesson number 2 of your book. So, in this lesson, we are going to start the grammar parts of lesson number 2. So, nous allons voir la partie grammaire de la leçon 2. Les adjectifs, interrogatifs, singuliers. So, the interrogative, adjective is singular. So, here you can see adjective, interrogative, singulier, masculine, feminine. So, you have in singular form, masculine and feminine form. Can and care. So, this can is ending with one L. This can is ending with double L, T in feminine. So, here I have given some example. Can a tone no? So, can a tone no? So, no is masculine. So, can means mono a Pierre. What is your name? Pierre. He's going to answer Pierre or Christine. Any feminine or masculine. No bother about the gender. So, can a tone no? So, no is masculine. So, we are going to add Q-U-E-N. Okay? So, tu as quel âge? How old are you? Tu as quel âge? So, âge is also masculine. So, if the noun is masculine, you are going to put a masculine adjective. If the noun is feminine, you are going to add feminine adjective. Okay? So, you have, how old are you? I am 13 years old. J'ai 13 ans. Okay? Il ne faut pas dire je suis présent. I am in English is je suis. But for age, you are going to write avoir. Next. Quel est ton address? What is your address? Quel est ton address? Address is féminin. Une adresse only. Donc, on va mettre adjectif au féminin. Qu'est-ce que l'interrogatif? Au féminin. Je suis dans la rue 8 Suffren Pondicherry. Okay, so I am in the 8th street, Suffren Street, Pondicherry. I am living there. Okay, so next, quelle ville tu habites? In which city you are living? So, quelle ville? Ville is also feminine now. So, quelle, we are going to put the adjective feminine adjective. Okay, j'habite à Paris. I live in Paris. So, it is clear for adjective, interrogative, singulier, masculine and feminine. I hope it is clear for you for this. Okay, it is very easy and simple for you. So, on va passer à la deuxième partie de la grammaire. Les prépositions de lieu. We already learned in your previous lesson. Place stand of the preposition of places. So, ici. Près de, derrière. So, ici means here. Près de, nearby. Behind, derrière means behind. Ou devant, before. Okay, so you have many places of preposition of places. Here I have given you some only. Okay, so, and habite ici. These are all a small recap of your previous book in this lesson. Okay, so the grammar will be short for you, because you already learned this in your apprenant and deux, trois. Okay? So, ici, elle habite ici. She lives here. Elle habite ici. So, où est le sac? Where is the bag? It is here. Il est, c'est ici. Où est ta maison? Where is your house? Where is your house? C'est près d'ici. It's nearby. Here, okay, or you can say derrière la porte, it is behind the bank. Derrière is behind, okay. Où est Nisha? Where is Nisha? Elle est derrière chantier. So, where is Nisha? She is behind chantier, okay. So, you can see the preposition of places in the sentence and les interrogations et l'intonation. So, interrogation and intonation. These are three types of interrogation form. A simple interrogation form using SFT and the intonation form using the reversible verb. Okay? So, let's So here I am giving you two examples. Où habites-tu? Where do you live? Où habites-tu? Où with also is where. So another example, next example, vous êtes à l'école ou à la maison. So you are in school or in your house. So you are there or somewhere else. Okay, so où with accent is where, où without accent is or. Okay, so this is over for this class and I hope you are going to do your exercise without doubt, or if you have doubt you can refer the grammar class and do the assignment for the next class. Thank you.